It is a fallacy that we have to accept more glare in exchange for greater road illumination. Part of this has to do with luminance, as discussed in the previous video, and part of it has to do with that bluer headlights cause more glare without providing much benefit to the driver. Brightness is perceived differently from a small glare source than in general in more naturalistic settings. And the luminosity function was designed for the latter, so it's a general tool to estimate perceived brightness based on spectral composition. And although it is still used in specifications for automotive headlights, it cannot account for the fact that short wavelength, so bluer light, contributes more to brightness perception when it comes to glare. This is a well-known issue with several theoretical solutions suggested, but real-life practice is still lagging behind. Therefore, the currently used measures of luminous intensity underestimate glare from bluer light sources like LED or HID headlights relative to halogens. Now, the narrative explanation behind all of this is that in nature, blue light always comes only when the sun is high and always from the large, homogeneous area of the sky. And although blue light is a stressor, it is necessary to activate us for the activities of the day, but as a stressor, it's also there to warn us for the potential dangers coming from too intense sunlight. Now, when we take this blue light and present it from a tiny glare source in the otherwise dark night, that is the exactly opposite kind of context to where it is natural. And indeed, many experiments have shown that a cool LED headlight, all else being equal, is going to be perceived as brighter and is going to create more glare than an equally powerful halogen headlight, without even providing better road illumination, with some caveats. I'll get back to that in a second. Meanwhile, the industry started a race towards bluer and bluer headlights within the allowable range for white light, but in many cases they also exceeded this range, so far without legal consequences. Furthermore, modern plastic projector headlights have a higher tendency to separate colors within the beam pattern, and that leads to a greater deviation of colors, so some parts of the beam are going to be more likely to go outside of the allowable white zone, thereby contributing further to glare. Okay, so on to the question that everybody keeps asking. It seems logical that glare is a type of pain, so it's there to warn us for danger. And also we know that blue light is a stressor to all tissues, and through their phototoxicity, they create byproducts which can be damaging to highly sensitive tissues like the retina. So it's logical to ask whether modern LED headlights can be dangerous. And surprisingly, the short answer is that no one really knows. Most of the big institutions claim that this is not the case. ANSES, which is the French agency for all things safety, has a contrarian opinion, and they claim that regulations today do not protect properly for potential harms from LED headlights. Okay, so they are more glaring, but maybe it's worth it. Are there any advantages in terms of road illumination? As I alluded to this before, while they are clearly more glaring, there seems to be no evidence for any area where they have benefits. Now, one theoretical exception is peripheral detection, where they should provide better detection performance. And this has been tested in a couple of small experiments, but nothing really conclusive, and they occasionally found some such effect, but the effect is very small, and wherever it was found, it was beyond 45 degrees eccentricity. So it's quite questionable how much it translates to real life driving visibility benefits. And in everything else, bluer headlights are also worse for the driver. So they lower visual acuity, which means that things will appear less sharp. And also, dark adaptation is slowest after exposure to blue light. Now, this latter is very important and relevant to driving, and together with the increased luminance contrast on the road with modern headlights, this is the reason behind the often noted tunnel vision, so that the driver can see more within the beam pattern, but less outside of it. Also, in bad weather like rain or fog, the light that is reflected is going to be more disturbing for the driver with a bluer headlight. In the previous video, we saw that a Gaussian intensity distribution is a visual cue for glare. And the reason, one of the reasons why that is the case, is that light also scatters within the eye. Now, the two most important optical media in this question are the cornea and the lens, both of which scatter blue light more. Some light also enters the eye from the side, and some light within the eye gets reflected from the back of the eye, and these two locations scatter red light more. And when it comes to this mechanism, there is a huge individual variability depending on eye pigmentation, so individual genetics. In general, aging affects both of these mechanisms negatively, so the cornea and the lens yellows, and thereby more blue light is going to be scattered. But the pigmentation of the eye also decreases, so more red light is going to be scattered. But for everybody, blue light is scattered more within the eye than yellow light. And this type of intraocular scatter affects primarily disability glare, so not so much discomfort glare, which is how painful the glare source is, but disability glare means that any target which is not the glare source itself is going to be less likely to be detected. And so we saw that bluer headlights increase disability glare, and aging also increases disability glare. So our aging population on the road, understandably, starts to question their visual abilities, and they look for solutions like trying to sit up higher so that they get less glare from other headlights of other cars, and also to buy a new car with powerful headlights so that hopefully they can see more. And obviously the modern SUV of this kind of solution is going to create more glare for everybody else. So the vicious circle closes, which is awesome for the industry, but such arms race on the road is not going to solve the problems of glare, while better designed products actually could. So, in conclusion, bluer headlights are more glaring, and while they hold also several disadvantages to the driver, they provide little to no benefit in terms of quality of road illumination. And part of their popularity and the coolness factor of LED headlights comes from that they appear brighter than how well they actually illuminate. And similarly to the issues around luminance in the previous video, we can conclude that the old measures, which were adequate to halogen headlights and which are still in use, are no longer adequate to measure and compare modern headlights. And when it comes to intraocular scatter of light, we see that blue light is scattered more in the eyes of everybody than yellow light, while older people have generally greater issues regarding light scatter. So I hope that in these two videos I have shown the most important factors of glare and how they are very unrelated to road illumination, and therefore the issue of glare could be largely solved. The only thing missing for that is the awareness and the will to change. So please spread the word.